necklace and the treasure.
Throw pirate treasure.
Bring them dock. Engines bring freight cars. Cranes unload cargo. And ships bring visitors.
Put the Thomas pajamas on next time.
One day, Thomas had to collect a very important visitor, the Admiral. Thomas was to take the Admiral to open the new Maritime Museum. It was a museum all about the sea. Salty was excited. The Admiral is always looking for the lost pirate treasure of Sodor, he said. Pirates? Scoffed James. Treasure? Huffed Emily. Yes, said Sodor. No one has ever found it. Salty told him there were three clues. First, find the Eagle of the Mountains. Its beak will point to the clouds, not in the sky. Then, those clouds will lead to the Skull and Crossbones. And there, you'll find the treasure, me hearties. Eagle, clouds, Skull and Crossbones, tooted Thomas, excitedly. I'm sure I could solve those clues. Emily and James thought it was all nonsense, and that made Thomas cross. Just then, the Admiral arrived. Thomas puffed off to collect it.
Oh. Good boy.
The Admiral had to be at the museum in time for the grand opening.
You want to take it off?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Thomas felt very proud to be taking it. What if I arrive at the Admiral and the chest of pirate treasure, thought Thomas. That would show James and Emily. So Thomas chuffed onto the track away from the museum and set off into the mountains to look for the first clue.
Look!
What?
Look!
Vincent, you gotta take a dress. Come on, baby.
How could clouds not be
on the sky? Come on, listen nice. Look at this.
Thomas
baby,
knew
when
he had
poop.
Never seen a
look.
Skull and crossbones
poop
anywhere.
What's wrong?
Later, Emily popped towards Thomas. There's no such thing
no
as treasure,
no.
She laughed.
Come on, you gotta go to school.
But Thomas paid no attention.
Yeah.
The Eagle of the Mountains had to be somewhere. Then he saw something wonderful. A mountain that looked like an eagle.
You go to school.
Thomas was very excited.
Come on, you go to school. I'm going to see you tomorrow.
He hooted happily. Now I'll find the next one. The eagle's head would point the way. Suddenly, Thomas saw a track leading in the direction of the stone beach. Where are you going, Thomas? Pleased James. To find the clouds that are not in the sky, whispered Thomas. How silly.
What's wrong, babies?
Snorted James.
I need to chuck you now. You're a big boy.
But Thomas didn't mind. He knew the clouds were here somewhere. Then he saw them. The clouds not in the sky were reflections of clouds in the lake. I found the second clue, reached Thomas excitedly. One more, and I'll find the treasure.
Right, let me just put the shirt on. Then you can rest for a little bit.
Thomas looked for a long time.
Okay.
And he forgot all about the Admiral. Then Harold arrived with Sir Topham Hatt.
The Admiral is late for the opening of the museum, he boomed crossly. You have been unreliable, added Sir Topham Hatt. Harold will now take the Admiral to the museum.
Thomas felt very
ow.
Good. If only he hadn't spent so much time looking for the clue.
You know how big boy you've been.
Fancy believing in a silly old story, laughed Harold.
Yay.
Everyone thinks I'm silly, Puff Thomas.
but I still believe there's treasure. Thomas puffed sadly along the track away from the lake. Thomas had never been this way before, so he didn't know where it would lead. It led him into a tunnel. At last, Thomas came to the end of the line. He was surprised. There were all the other engines. And there was the Admiral.
I am very proud to declare the new Maritime Museum open,
he announced.
Everyone
cheered. He's not a baby anymore, you're now a big boy.
So something even more exciting. That's it, Thomas tooted. The pirate treasure's right here. Don't be silly, puffed Emily. Everyone knows it's just a silly old story, snorted James. But Thomas knew he was right. I followed all the clues, he puffed proudly.
And you have found the skull and crossbones, cried the Admiral.
Everyone was surprised.
Someone get me a shovel!
The Admiral was so excited he dug for the pirate treasure himself. He found a big wooden chest. Inside was the pirate treasure.
The pirate treasure will be the most important thing in the whole museum, said the Admiral.
Thomas, boomed Sir Topham Hatt, you have made this the best opening ever. Thomas was very proud. He had been right to believe in Salty's story. He had found the treasure. Thomas and the Treasure. Brendam Docks is a very busy place. Engines bring freight cars, cranes unload cargo, and ships bring visitors. One day, Thomas had to collect a very important visitor, the Admiral. Thomas was to take the Admiral to open the new Maritime Museum. It was a museum all about the sea. Salty was excited.
What do you want, Angel?
The Admiral is always looking for the lost pirate treasure of Sodor, he said.
Pirates? Scoffed James. Treasure? Puffed Emily.
Yes, said Sodor, but no one has ever found it.
Salty told them there were three clues.
First, find the eagle of the mountains. Its beak will point to the clouds, not in the sky. Then, those clouds will lead to the skull and crossbones. And there, you'll find the treasure, me huckies.
Eagle, clouds, skull and crossbones, tooted Thomas, excited. I'm sure I could solve those clues. Emily and James thought it was all nonsense, and that made Thomas cross. Just then, the Admiral arrived. Thomas puffed off to collect it. The Admiral had to be at the museum in time for the grand opening. Thomas felt very proud to be taking it. What if I arrived with the Admiral and the chest of pirate treasure, thought Thomas. That would show James and Emily. So Thomas chuffed onto the track away from the museum and set off into the mountains to look for the first clue. How could an eagle point the way, wondered Thomas? How could clouds...